So here's the plan. I'm flying from Bali, Indonesia,
to the UK. But before I go, I need to change.
Before I go to the UK, I'll spend 18 hours in Qatar. Welcome to the layover. But I don't know anything about Qatar.
Seven countries make up the Arab Peninsula: Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Oman, United Arab Emirates, Qatar, the small island nation of Bahrain, and Kuwait. But the country I'm going to is Qatar. Famous for its airways, news network Al Jazeera, and soon to be hosting the World Cup in 2022. Unlike many nations that joined the Arab Spring, Qatar remains stable, with Qatar also supporting uprisings in some nations. Qatar has a population of 1.8 million, although 85% of the population are migrant workers and rarely have citizenship rights. For those that do, they become some of the richest citizens in the world per capita. With Qatar's oil wealth and its king Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thayyan, is able to offer free education, healthcare, oh, and the country's also tax-free.
Right, got it. Okay, so it's almost midnight and I've arrived in Doha, Qatar right now. What do I need to do? So I need to just go, get the visa, and then pass through the gate, and get to the town, get to a hotel. Okay, so got the visas. It's quite simple and easy. You can even pay with a credit card. Next thing now is to take out some money from an ATM, get a taxi, hit the hotel. Getting at the airport wasn't so bad, and getting into a taxi, so far so good. The taxi seems to be taking us straight into the city. And then we'll get to the hotel. So, yeah, great, checked in. Everything's pretty nice and quick. Hotel is nice. Got upgraded to a bigger room. Got a bedroom here, but also got a living room. Ooh, so far so good. So I'm gonna go and have a quick check of the bay. So it looks like with all the lights and everything. I don't know if you can see me here in the darkness, but I've made it to the skyline here of Qatar. So it's about 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm just gonna go back to the hotel. I'm really tired. I wanna see if I can check out the rest of the city. It looks really beautiful. Seems to be really safe, no kind of problems here. So let's see what it looks like tomorrow. Okay, washed, ready. ready to go and hit the city. But it seems like the Doha is quite quiet, or Qatar is even quite quiet. One of the main things that you can go and visit is the Islamic Art Center, but today it's closed. Yay! So, trying to find out what's left. It's going to be like shopping centers and whatever. So, let's see what we can find that's open and we can see in a few hours. So, we're just walking and asking for directions. We stopped this guy, asked him for like how to get to this this like shopping center place here that's supposed to be good. He asked me, do you have a car? I said, no, I don't have a car, I'm just gonna walk. But it's just 15 minutes. He says, okay, I take you. And then like he just put us here, like no problem. Pretty nice. Okay, let's see what this place has to offer. Okay, so my time in Qatar has come to an end, and overall I think the experience was quite nice. Qatar is a very clean, very organized country, and it's one of the richest countries in the world per capita, right? So I would kind of expect that. It seems to be working very well, but I wonder who it's working very well for. Well, I guess clearly the 15% of Qataris that are the residents here, but the 85% of the migrants that kind of seem to be passing through. And just in the short time that I was here, and I can't fully evaluate how that actually is, it seems that people has come in here on short-term contracts, like two-year contracts, which they're kind of tied up into, and they're not really kind of making the money that they hoped to make when they came out here. Everybody I spoke to, they kind of felt that it was quite tough and they just want to go home because actually they're not making any more money than when they were back home. So these are the people that are building this place, right? And they, for a large percent of the time, they make up 85% of the population. But I wonder how much they're catered for and supported. You know, as I said, the people that I met, and it's definitely not a strong statistical study, didn't seem to be very happy and just couldn't wait to go home. I think the country is, it's nice, but touristically, I don't really see that there's much to do here. The main place that seems to be of interest is this, the Islamic Art Museum, but unfortunately the day that we were here it was closed, so that was a bit of a bummer. Otherwise, like, was kind of struggling to see what there was to do outside of shopping centres. And for me, it's okay. Like, I mean, the shopping centres look really great, they're really clean, they're really wonderful. But for me, it's really boring. I was looking for something a bit more interesting and a bit more cultural. You do have this kind of cultural quarter of the city, but it looks like they're just kind of building it or maybe refurbishing it. And the style looks kind of really cool and really awesome. But I kind of felt like I had the same experience when I went to the Epcot Center in Disney World. So, you know, there was the little Morocco, which also looked very awesome, and it didn't look that different to this little square. But this is the kind of the Middle East, and you'd kind of expect something a bit more cultural, a bit more interesting that's kind of going on. So from that aspect, I guess I was a little disappointed. It seems that one of the main things to do is these kind of like safari weekends, and I wish that I had some time to kind of do that, and maybe next time when I'm here I'll definitely come and check that out, but on this occasion it didn't happen. Anyway, Qatar, it's been great. Thanks a lot for your time.